towards rapid stride of development. Navsari Agricultural University.
Namaskar. Welcome to Navsari Krishi University. To pave the way for rapid progress in agriculture, the state government of Gujarat aligned the Gujarat Agricultural University, established in 1972, into four separate universities in the year 2004.
Navsari Agricultural University came into existence from 1st May 2004 and Navsari, Bharuch, Narmada, Tapi, Dang, Valsad and Surat districts of South Gujarat were placed under its jurisdiction.
Topographically, the South Gujarat region is spread over 26.63 lakh hectare area with ample resources and rich in biodiversity.
The fertile middle plain is encompassed by 170 km seashore on western side and hilly and tribal area of Dangs and Dharampur covered by beautiful mountains with dense forest. These natural resources are backbone of the economical development of the South Gujarat. The big rivers like Narmada, Tapi, Purna, Ambika and Damanganga passes through this land, mythically known as Land of Lord Parashuram, receives an average annual rainfall ranging from 80 to 100 inches.
The Navsari Agricultural University, which has held farmers' heart captive, resolute its motto from ancient Vedas, Krishi Mula Riddhi, which means prosperity remains in universe by the virtue of agriculture.
The major goal of Navsari Agricultural University is to uplift the livelihood and economic status of farmers. To achieve this goal, NAU has started multifaceted activities like education, research and extension education in agriculture on a sprawling farmland measuring about 400 hectares situated on historic Dandi March Road, 3 kilometers away from Navsari Railway Station.
The first aim of Navsari Agricultural University is to provide education in agriculture, horticulture, forestry and other allied fields of agriculture.
Education. The NM College of Agriculture was established in 1965 with the aim of providing agricultural education. NMCA is offering undergraduate program of BSc Agri of 8 semesters, that is 4 years duration. It also offers MSc Agri having 2 years residential requirement and PhD in agriculture with 3 years residential requirement in various disciplines. Since its inception, NMCA accorded BSc Agri degree to 2,779 students, MSc Agri to 869 students, and PhD to 212 students. The ASPI College of Horticulture and Forestry was established in 1989. It offers BSc in Horticulture and Forestry, each of 4 years duration. PG course of MSc having 2-year duration and PhD of 3-year duration in both horticulture and forestry. Till date, ASPI College of Horticulture produced 262 BSc Horti, 104 MSc Horti and 9 PhD Horti students, whereas the College of Forestry awarded 201 BSc, 51 MSc and 1 PhD degrees to the students. To help agriculture and industrial sectors and to develop core competence by bringing out professional managers equipped with modern management theories, the university has started 2 years residential postgraduate program in agribusiness management in the academic year 2007-08. The College of Animal Husbandry and Veterinary Sciences was established in 2008 under One Bandhu program, sponsored by the state government. It aims to provide and train through practices of animal husbandry and veterinary. It accolades BVSc, MVSc and PhD degree after successful completion of each program. Considering the technological advancement worldwide, the university has initiated the postgraduate program in Information and Communication Technology and Post-Harvest Technology and Food Process Engineering. Under RAVE program, undergraduate students are kept in different villages to acquaint with rural environment and for the experienced learning in agriculture. Moreover, the students are also made to visit research station, industrial units located within the state or to other states. Number of Luminous students have successfully completed National Eligibility Test, that is NET, and ARS level competitive exams and joined in various institutes including NAU. The university provides excellent hostel facilities to the students of all the faculties for residence to provide suitable environment for the education. There is a separate student council and placement cell established in the university to avail them employment opportunities through on-campus selection process.
Besides graduate, postgraduate and doctorate program, the university also offers various diploma and short-term training certificate courses with full facilities at various centers under its jurisdiction.
3 years diploma course in Agricultural Polytechnic at Bharuch and Vyara, Horticulture Polytechnic at Navsari, Agricultural Engineering Polytechnic at Dediyapada, Corporation Banking and Marketing Polytechnic at Vaghai, short-term certificate courses in 20-week training program in bakery production at Navsari, livestock attendant training at Livestock Training Center, Navsari, gardeners training at Landscaping and Gardening Training Center at Navsari.
Thus, Navsari Agricultural University is providing excellent platform to the students for building their education career and bright future prospects.
Agricultural research.
The second mandate of Navsari Agricultural University is research in agriculture and other allied fields. Considering the different agroclimatic situation of South Gujarat region, the research in agricultural crops is carried out at 15 various research stations.
The research activities are carried out for improvement of varieties and crop production technology for sugarcane, pulses, castor, mango, sapota, banana, coconut, papaya, flowers, vegetable, tubers, oil palm, forage and spices and condiments. In addition to this, research on water and soil management and livestock are also carried out at Navsari Center. Moreover, the well-equipped state-of-the-art modern laboratories like Central Instrumentation Laboratory, Tissue Culture Laboratory, Pesticide Residue Laboratory, Food Quality Testing Laboratory, Biocontrol Laboratory, Biofertilizer and Biopesticide Laboratory are established. Experience learning to students is provided through processing units of mango, tomato and onion. In addition to those, the university has regional as well as sub-research station at various agroclimate zones of South Gujarat to perform research activities of concerned region. These are Bharuch, Desi Cotton and Pigeon Pea, Surat, Cotton and Sorghum, Paria, Mango, Sapota and Cashew Nut, Vyara, Paddy, Summer Groundnut, Surti Buffalo and Oil Seeds, Vaghai, Minor Millets like Nagli, Vari, Khodra, Paddy, Tubers and Vegetables, Gandevi, Banana, Sapota, Coconut and Black Pepper, Bardoli, Wheat and Paddy, Achalia, Cotton, Pigeon Pea, Water Management and Jatropha, Tancha, Green Gram, Pigeon Pea, Unirrigated Wheat and Sorghum, Hansot, Cotton, Pigeon Pea and Jatropha, Danti, Saline Soil Reclamation, Paddy and Brackish Aquaculture, Vanarasi, Kharsani, Soyabean and Maura, Dediyapada, Pulses, Sorghum, Groundnut and Drilled Paddy, Mangrol, Pulses, Sorghum and Jatropha.
With intensive endeavor of scientists, the university has achieved various statures.
Developed 13 new varieties in sugarcane, cotton, Indian bean, pigeon pea, paddy and banana. Develop a precision model by successfully integrating the banana tissue culture, drip irrigation, nutrient management and mulching technology. For efficient control of fruit fly, in banana, sapota, guava and vegetables, the university has developed Navroji trap. Develop biocontrol strategies for the control of sugarcane woolly aphids and cotton mealybugs. Rearing of parasitic insects like Trichogamma chilonis for control of borers in sugarcane and to make it available for farmers at suitable prices. For efficient biocontrol of cotton and vegetable sucking pests, Chrysoperla carnea, the predators have been developed at large scale by university and distributes among farmers. The Trichoderma culture for the control of sugarcane red rot and wilt has been mass produced by the university. In the late 90s, all the sugar factories in the region were compelled to carry out aerial spray for the control of sugarcane pyrrhea, a severe pest causing substantial yield and quality losses in sugarcane, which drains lakhs of rupees of farmers towards cost and application of insecticides. In the year 1990, an effective parasitoid named Apericania malinoleuca was introduced from other states and was introduced successfully in sugarcane ecosystem. Now, this Apericania is established so well in the region that now pyrrhea is considered as a minor pest in sugarcane. With the development of new varieties and technologies, the productivity of various crops per hectare has increased considerably. For example, sugarcane 67 to 77 ton per hectare, cotton 451 to 563 kg lint, paddy 1.6 to 2 ton, banana 40.26 to 61.54 tons, vegetables 12.24 to 13.75 ton. Many farmers have adopted technology developed for reclamation of saline soil through drainage technology and made it suitable for farming. The recommendation made on the basis of research on micro irrigation has helped farmers in reducing water consumption to the tune of 30 to 50% and also saving 20 to 30% use of fertilizers and obtaining 20 to 60% more crop production as well. Prepared land use planning models for considering land and climate for 37 talukas of South Gujarat to get hand-in information for suitable crop for the particular given area. Intensive efforts have been made since 2004 to make stride in research on organic farming by earmarking 10 hectares of land exclusively to facilitate research on organic farming.
Constant efforts are made by the university to avail new improved varieties along with certified and pure seeds to the farmers.
To make this possible, university has set up seed processing plant and seed testing laboratories at various centers. During the year 2009-10, it has produced and sold seeds and propagated plants.
The university has many national and state level multi-facet schemes under its belt. It includes
State Level Plan Schemes 122, State Level Non-Plan Schemes 81, National Level ICAR Schemes 60, Other Agency Schemes 80.
In all, 343 national and state level schemes on different aspects of agriculture and allied fields are functioning under university.
Extension activities.
The third and imperative mandate of university is agriculture extension education. Technology generated by scientists should reach to the ultimate beneficiaries, that is, farmers.
To facilitate extension activities, the university has established separate office of the Directorate of Extension Education in the year 2004. The DEE integrates and coordinates all extension activities under its able guidance. the agriculture technologies are transferred to farmers through 11 extension centers. For successful maneuvers of extension education, the scientists provide training to the farmers and extension functionaries to increase production, as well as to entrepreneurs to build up new agro-based industries. Moreover, university also organizes short and long-term training programs for farmers, youths, entrepreneurs, and agricultural organizations. For the development of animal husbandry, the university regularly organizes animal clinic camp, animal husbandry shibir, and special training programs and lectures. To provide hand-on information pertaining to package of practices and other technology to the farmers, the university regularly publishes leaflet, folders, and booklet in vernacular language.
With the aim to transfer agricultural technology to the rural farmers, the Indian Council of Agricultural Research, New Delhi, established Krushi Vignan Kendra, popularly known as Science Centers, in South Gujarat.
Four Krushi Vignan Kendras, that is KVKs, have been sanctioned and established under the jurisdiction of NAU. Trainings pertaining to agriculture, vocational, self-employment, etc. are imparted to the farmers of 10 villages, adopted by satellite village approach. The field demonstrations and frontline demonstrations are organized by KVKs at farmers' field to verify and acclimatize newly improved varieties under different climatic conditions.
On the occasion of celebration of centenary year of Sardar Patel, Sardar Smriti Kendra Navsari was established in 1978 at university campus entirely by public funding.
At Sardar Smriti Kendra, that is SSK, farmers are provided short-term training regarding crop production technology and other related fields. Training is also organized for extension functionaries, including village-level workers. Training for farm women are conducted related to home science, child care, child nutrition, house decoration, and kitchen gardening. Fully infrastructures, including well-furnished Kisan Ghar and transportation facility for field visit, are also provided to farmers.
Single window delivery system for technology products, diagnostic services and information are provided here at Agricultural Information Technology Center.
At ATIC, farmers get on-the-spot information regarding their field problems and can also purchase seeds, biofertilizers, etc.
To transfer technology from lab to land, state government-sponsored extension system named Training and Visit Scheme is functioning.
Under T&V scheme, that is Training and Visit Scheme, higher extension functionaries of the line departments are trained through pre-season and bi-monthly workshops.
Farmers' benefited activities are organized regularly at university campus throughout the year. Crop seminars, workshops, symposiums and field trips are organized regularly by Navsari Agricultural University.
University plays major role in Krishi Mahotsav, organized by state government every year, by transferring the technologies to the farmers of each village of South Gujarat. Live demonstrations are being arranged by concerned research station to disseminate technologies to the farmers. To make them adopt the technology, Farmers Day is organized every year.
Friends, we all know Gujarat has already been accepted as a model of the development in the country. Agriculture of Gujarat has also developed very fast during the last 12-10 years. South Gujarat region of the Gujarat has also significantly contributed in the development of agriculture in the state. Navsari Agriculture University is highly engaged in developing a new technology and entrepreneurship for the further development of agriculture sector in South Gujarat region. I hope that farmers of Gujarat will take all this new technology and services of Navsari Agriculture University for further development of agriculture sector in South Gujarat and in Gujarat state.
Infrastructural facilities.
The developmental activities taking place within the campus is equally supported by excellent infrastructure facilities.
The central library containing 34,089 books, 49,218 synopses and 10,421 bound volumes and theses. The library is also equipped with internet facilities. High-tech computer networking facility. Large playground, sports hall, as well as modern gym. Playgroup and primary school within the campus. Bus facility from campus to city visit. SBI branch with locker and ATM facility. Post office, primary health center and provision store facility. Modern guest house, relax house and farmer's home. Auditorium and cultural platform for students and agri families. Water purifier plant for students, agri families and visitors. Horticulture nursery providing decorative plants and trees. Modern hostel amenities for students and canteen for staff.
Navsari Agricultural University is a pilgrimage for farmers. Thousands of farmers acquire scientific knowledge about agriculture and utilize it in their practices, making their life happy and prosperous.
The graduate and postgraduate students of Navsari Agricultural University have brought about many path-breaking ideas and showing their luminous knowledge to the world.
Navsari Agricultural University is a sacred place for farmers. The holy Ganga of agricultural information is gushing over from Navsari Agricultural University. As inscripted in Vedas, Krishi Mula Riddhihi, which means prosperity in the universe remains by the virtue of agriculture. Navsari Agricultural University is reverberating these lines and making its presence felt to the global world.
Towards rapid stride of development, Navsari Agricultural University.
Agri-media.